Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to the subject Electromagnetic Field Theory. This video is from the 13th chapter of this subject. The chapter name is Electromagnetic Radiation and Antennas. We started this chapter with the first topic, that is the basic radiation principles, the Hertzian dipole we have seen. So where a differential length of the current carrying element we have seen to have radiation into the surroundings. So for that we have derived the expressions for the magnetic field as well as for the electric field from which the radiated power can be derived. So we have seen that the antenna is actually the interface which converts VI waves into the EH waves and from EH waves back to the VI waves when operating as transmitting or receiving antenna, the corresponding radiation and induction phenomena there it will be taking place. So from the Hertzian dipole, the various types of antennas are popular these days. We shall be discussing in very brief the specific types here. So let us begin with antenna types. So the basic types of antennas, we can have a simple classification. So we shall be going first of all for the log periodic antennas. The log periodic antennas is having the two types, that is bow tie antenna and the log periodic dipole antenna. As the word suggests, dipole are the two poles here. So very first of all, for the log periodic dipole antenna, we can say that it is a multi-element directional narrow beam antenna and that works on a wide range of frequencies. The multi-elements onto this particular axis can be shown like this. The specific dimensions will be there here. And these multi-elements will be having the production of directional radiation pattern. This antenna is made up of series of dipoles. So this is one dipole, second dipole we can say. And these are placed along the antenna axis at different space intervals. And these are followed by logarithmic function of the frequency. Therefore, the name is log periodic antenna. The second type we talked into the same, that is the bow tie antenna. So for bow tie type of antenna, the simple diagram can be drawn like this. So it will be having the shape of like this. The length of the antenna can be denoted from this one. It looks like the bow of the tie, and the directivity we can denote by capital D here for these two elements here, which will be acting as the dipoles here. After this type of antenna, we have another type, that is of wire antennas. The wire antennas can be classified in terms of the short dipole antennas, monopole antennas, and the loop antennas. So as the name suggests, the dipole antenna can be having such orientation. This is the field given, or these two dimensions are same, or it may be having this particular orientation. So the launch of electromagnetic wave for radiation purpose by such a system will produce the horizontally polarized electromagnetic wave. The type of polarization of antenna can be said to be the horizontally polarized, whereas for such a configuration we can say it is having the vertical polarization. Both are of linear type. The various types of dipole antennas we can decide depending on the length here. So the length is always related with the wavelength of the electromagnetic wave which is generated from this particular radiating elements in general, we can say. So the designs are several types of designs. So it is having the two effective poles, hence called the dipoles. Now talking about the short dipole antenna, as we have said, the length of the dipole antenna is always compared with that of the wavelength. When we come to know that the length is less than lambda by 10, so that time we can say that the dipole antenna is a short dipole antenna. After dipole antenna, we have the type of antenna to be the monopole antenna. The name can be given monopole antenna. As the name suggests, dipole, the two poles, monopole suggests only one pole. In this case, the diagram of the antenna can be drawn like this. So this is the supply given to only one pole, and here we have a perfect conductor that is grounded here. For the dipole, the length can be the twice L. Here the L simply can be given for the only one pole. So monopole generally have the radiation of isotropic type. After the dipole and monopole, into the wire antennas we have the loop antennas also. So the loops can be shown to have feed like this, and this will be the small loop considering the symmetry here. So the feed shall be given directed in this particular direction from one end to the another end here, and the radiation will be taking place because of such a loop. The antenna is called as loop antenna. After dipole, monopole and the loop type of wire antennas, we have another classification to have traveling wave antennas. In the traveling wave antennas, we have helical antennas. So helical antennas can be shown or simply can be called as helix also. So if certain feed is given, so such a helix of the wire can be done here. So dimensions will be definitely effective to produce certain type of radiation here. Talking about the polarization, generally the dipoles antenna are having the linear polarization. The helix antenna produces the circular polarization for the electromagnetic radiation here. After this helix antenna, or also called as helical antenna, we have Yagi-Uda antenna. So Yagi-Uda antenna is basically the array antenna. So in this array antenna, the diagram can be shown. This is the antenna axis, and onto this antenna axis, the dipole elements are equally spaced, and they are having the normal orientation, that is the perpendicular orientation with the antenna axis. So there shall be n number of elements into the array antenna, we can say. So this is also the type of antenna. After which, the very popular nowadays is microwave antenna. So as we have gone through the understanding of transmission lines of type strip lines and microstrip lines, so from the microstrip line patch we can have the radiation. The diagram can be shown. If this is the substrate, and onto this particular substrate the patch can be like this. This patch is given by certain feed, and this patch will have the radiations into the surroundings, which is called as the microstrip patch antenna here. After microstrip patch antenna, we have the reflector type of antennas. The corner reflector antenna can be shown like this. So a corner is formed between these two reflectors, and it will have the radiation from such a reflector. The dimensions can be shown. This is the capital D dimension, this is the capital H, and the capital L. The length can be shown on either sides here. So after the corner reflector type of antenna, we have parabolic reflector antennas also, the most commonly called as the dish antenna. So this dish antenna is having a central reflector also sometimes. So it is having radiation into the surroundings. So the parabolic reflectors are the highly directional antennas, which have the intended direction for the radiation. So these were the various types of antennas to be discussed into the briefs. In the next video, we shall be deriving the radiation because of the half wave dipole or the quarter wave monopole. Depending on the length of such dipoles, the names are given, which we shall see into the details into the next video, followed by certain antenna specifications where we can have the formalization, and in the problem practice we have to derive certain measurements with respect to the given antenna types. So I hope the things are very much clear. The details can be given if you are opting for the subjects like microwave engineering and the antenna and radiation especially. So if you are liking these particular topics and want to get more information on electromagnetic field theory, you can subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you.